It's a basic truth of Catholic teaching that we're wired for God. We're hungry for God. All of our desires in some way lead to that great desire for God. Therefore, if we block God out of our lives, we will be dissatisfied because we're going against our own nature. You learn to love the commandments because they're making you free.
Father Robert Barron is one of the most sought-after speakers on the spiritual life. From prestigious universities to YouTube, this podcasting priest is on a mission to evangelize.
Yeah, I like The Departed from the standpoint of portraying evil. I think Scorsese is very good at showing the density of evil.
Father Barron is a professor, author, and prominent theologian from Mundelein Seminary near Chicago. He reaches millions of people through his media ministry, Word on Fire.
In the mind of the church, evangelization is the basic work. Declaring Jesus Christ is Lord. That means making Jesus Christ the center of your life. He's the answer. To evangelize is to say that. So Word on Fire's purpose is the ancient purpose of the church.
It's evangelization with a 21st century game plan. You can hear Father Barron on the Catholic Network Relevant Radio. Listen to him on satellite radio. Download homilies from his website. Hear and watch him on your iPod, or find him on YouTube, where his video commentaries draw thousands of viewers on the web.
I think if you go back to the earlier part of the 20th century, the church's view was, we build institutions and people will come to them. So we build schools and hospitals and parishes and seminaries, and indeed that immigrant generation came in great numbers, and there they were evangelized. But now that's not true. People aren't just going to spontaneously come to our institutions. I think we have to go out to get them. That's precisely where all the media available to us come into play. We have to use the computer, DVD, iPod, radio, television, whatever we have, because we've got to be much more proactive in reaching out to those that we want to evangelize.
And now we can reach out to support the innovative projects of one of the world's great teachers of Catholicism when the church needs it the most.
I am convinced that an awful lot of younger people were not well catechized. So in the years after Vatican II, there was kind of a drift or a certain lack of focus in our teaching. So I do discern the need, especially among younger people, to hear the clear message of the gospel.
Father Barron proclaims the gospel through compelling new media and plans to produce more. His DVDs are broadcast on the Eternal Word television network to 44 million viewers. Also, Catholics who have attended events by the Reverend Billy Graham have received copies of Father Barron's DVDs, which are also used by schools and parishes nationwide. The response is strong. People are coming into or back to the church at a time when others feel helpless or hopeless.
That's why evangelization is not a luxury, it's a necessity. It's like bread, it's like water, it's this essential element you need to feed your spiritual life. When the Lord said, you know, we do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God, that's what it means. You can be filled up with all the bread of the world, but you don't have the bread of life, you won't be satisfied. Oh, Jesus said, I've come that you might have life and have it to the full.
Father Barron's ministry follows the example of Archbishop Fulton Sheen, a pioneer who became a familiar voice of the church in the early days of broadcasting.
Then after Fulton Sheen, we kind of dropped the ball, and the Protestant churches really ran with it. They used the media very creatively. So it's always bothered me that we Catholics who led the way have fallen behind.
Father Barron wants Catholics back in the race. Now he's embarking on his most ambitious production to date, a landmark documentary series for television, DVD, and the internet. It will be an essential collection for every home, church, and university.
One thing I'm very excited about is this project I call the Catholicism Project. Catholicism is a world religion, spans the globe. One of the great memories I have is Easter Sunday. I was distributing communion at St. Peter's, and I came out from St. Peter's and looked out at this sea of people. And what it was an image of the international church. There's everybody under the sun. I'd like to show this Catholicism project to demonstrate the world-spanning quality of Catholicism. Secondly, Catholicism is a very visual religion. We're not just about the word, we're about sacrament, sign, color, art, architecture. We're a visual religion. Therefore, it's perfect to use video, to use visual media to explain the Catholic faith. I'd love to go around the world to some of the great sites of the Catholic world and explain Catholicism against the backdrop of these very visually arresting places and scenes. A lot of people tell the Catholic story, some who don't know much about it, some who are actively hostile to Catholicism, some in the media maybe in a sort of neutral way. I think Catholics have to seize the moment, and Catholics themselves have to say, here's what we're about, here's the richness of our tradition, and here's why we believe what we believe. Because if we don't tell the story, somebody else will. Nature abhors a vacuum. Someone will come in and start explaining what we're about. We need to tell the story.